tonight's Grand Final 1998, the nail-biting thrill of the tightrope, fast, fearsome action of Powerball, the agonizing ferocity of Duel, plus a man dressed as a giant chicken, not forgetting your hosts, Jeremy Guskett and Ulrika Johnson.
Arena here in Birmingham and to the grand final of Gladiators 1998. Now tonight's show is a charity show. Everyone here in the audience has paid £7.50 for their tickets, and the proceeds is going to go to a number of children's charities, but the main recipient is a children's charity called Action for Children. They're presently building a special home for autistic children here in Birmingham, so we'd like to take this opportunity to thank you very much for your kind generosity.
Our finalists are competing for some wonderful prizes. Tonight's winners will each receive £1,000, plus they'll be given the keys to one of these four-door, four-wheel drive utility trucks. Everyone here thinks they're fantastic, they are unbelievable, but it's only going to be our winners that are going to be driving away in them. The runners-up, although they're going to be disappointed, they're also going to get £1,000. Plus, we're going to get the sun to soak away their sorrow by flying them off to the Atlantis Resort on Paradise Island in the Bahamas.
So let's meet the finalists battling for those prizes. Tonight, they are Louise Ray
and Jane Smith.
To the final of Gladiators 1998. Did you ever dream you'd get this far?
I honestly can't believe it. All the training that we've done, all the preparation and going through all the trials and everything, you think, I've got another stage further, I've got another stage further, and then all of a sudden, it's here, it's unbelievable.
How do the children feel about it? Have they been able to follow it properly? Do they understand what's actually going on?
Yes, I think so. Now, they're 5, 6 and 7, so yes, they've been really good. They're really enthusiastic today.
Have you now started thinking about the prizes? I mean, you stand the chance of winning £1,000 and one of these absolutely fabuloso, handsome, good-looking trucks. How do you feel about that?
I'd love to get one of the trucks. We've actually had a four-wheel drive before, but we traded it in when I actually started the business. So, and the children were devastated because they thought it was really good fun sitting up really high. So it'd be brilliant to get one of those.
So they'll be egging you on tonight?
Yes, I think so. There'll be plenty of cheers from that quarter tonight.
Absolutely, and there will be from us here as well. Let's hear it for Louise Rains.
Jane, you've made it to the final. You fought a crazy guy against in Sheffield.
Yep.
Can you actually believe you're here?
To get this far, I never knew what to expect from Gladiators. Every round it just got better and better. My family, my friends, mum and dad, my boyfriend Andy have all encouraged me all the way. They just think it's brilliant.
What do you think about these great prizes?
They are really nice. I mean, either way, you're going to go away with something. A car would be very nice. But if you have to settle for the holiday, it's not too bad. But well, I prefer a car.
I'm sure you're going to give it your best shot. Let's give it up for Jane Smith.
To meet the guys tonight, they are Nilo Parsley
and Dave Walter.
Nilo, what percentage of your success is down to that crowd over there?
I'd say 99.9.
They really must lift you when you're going through the events, and particularly through the Eliminator as well.
Oh yeah, they're absolutely brilliant. When I come out every time, big roar, just what I want.
Now you do look feeling quite confident, or don't even want to speculate?
No, not even thinking. Just trying to relax, enjoy it. You never know what happens.
Well, listen, we're not going to ask you about how you fancy your chances. We're just going to wish you the very, very best of luck. Let's hear it for Neil Parsley.
Dave, you're a very unassuming individual. Do you ever get nervous? Do you feel the tension?
I do get nervous, yeah, I do feel the tension, but, you know, you've got such a great crowd here. They really make you feel at home, so it eases the nerves a little bit.
And it sounds as if thousands upon thousands have travelled up from Exeter.
Yeah, a fair few have travelled up from Exeter, but they've also come from up there, Newcastle, Durham, that area.
All over the country. And I suppose we ought to give a special mention to the chick and his chicks, or her chicks.
Yep, that's Chicky and his chicks.
Who are they?
You've got Chicky, you've got Manda, Kerri-Anne and Kath.
Best of luck to you, Dave. Let's give it up for Dave Walter.
Well, we've met our finalist. Now, all that remains to be said is let the final of Gladiators 1998 begin.
Our first female contender is Louise. And she's facing Lightning. Over to John Anderson.
Contender ready! Gladiator ready! 3, 2, 1!
The final is underway. If Louise is first to the top and back again, she'll score 10. Should Lightning win, then Louise will be dropped from the line in an explosive flash. Lightning! First to the changeover, unhitches, strikes the down button, and hooks up for the return journey. Louise, the Preston bridal shop owner, not wedded to this event, her first time on the rope and her last. Lightning coming home for the impact, boots Louise off the tightrope and into the safety net. James Fan, Sean Phillip, proud of Lightning for yet another faultless showing. Once again, she's outperformed all around her. Louise well short of the finish, Lightning strike means she's out of the point and into the net.
Second female contender is Jane. And she's facing Rebel. Over to John Anderson.
Contender ready! Gladiator ready! 3, 2, 1!
James had success on the high-tension tightrope before, scored 10 in a heat, now climbing fast in his final. She's going to make the changeover platform marginally ahead of Rebel. And it's all in the dismount, and Jane unbuckles, turns on a sixpence, and she's going to be flying down that tightrope at breakneck speed, and poor old Rebel knows she's in for a face full of netting. Impact for Jane, plunge time for Rebel. Jane's dad, Julian, boyfriend Andy, more than content with that 10-point opening. Double-footed impression on the pad for Jane, deep depression for Rebel.
Jane, what a fantastic start. You scored 10 points.
I was a bit wary of Rebel, but thankfully I've picked up 10 points.
Oh, yeah, you seem to fly that tightrope effortlessly. I mean, it's just...
It's my big monkey arms, that's what it is.
Big monkey arms. A great start. Rebel, I think you knew her up against it there.
No, I did. She may be a diver, but I know she's really good at the backstroke, so I'll give it to her.
Well said. Let's give it up for Rebel and Jane.
While Auntie Peggy and Cousin Joanne lead the cheers, let's review the scores. One event down, Louise remains on zero, Jane starts with 10.
Our first male contender is Leo. And he's facing Diesel. Over to John Anderson.
Contender!
Is the writing on the wall for Diesel? Well, it's certainly on the head of Neil's dad. Neil's first competition tightrope, and does it show? The Lancashire Rugby League professional all over the shop. Can he make up the time when he unshackles his harness? Diesel will be first to unbuckle. Slow with his hardware. Neil's got one chance to steal this. Oh, blimey, he's blown it. Diesel on the return journey. He won't be derailed. Neil might as well throw himself into the net now. Diesel wins it. Neil's tightrope history. Brian and Matty bitterly disappointed with that. Dave Walters fans glad Neil got a stuffing. She best not say stuffing in front of the bird.
That was useless, that one.
Disappointed with that one?
Yeah, a bit gutty.
Well, but,
plenty of games left.
Exactly, it is the first game and you've got lots of time to get some more points. Let's give it up for Neil and Diesel.
Dave Walters fans in full voice, singing man-sized chickens and green-haired trombone players. It's more like an episode of The X-Files, this. The truth is out there.
Our second male contender is Dave. And he's up against Ace. Over to John Anderson.
Contender!
In his heat, Dave was beaten on the tightrope by Ace. Dave, the chicken and chips fast food waiter from Exeter Way, needs to be quick if he's not to be basted and beaten on the tightrope once again. Dave's first to the platform. Simultaneous drop down. Who's going to get away first? Eight is one-handed. Dave's away. It's going to be tight on the rope. Eight wins it. Not exactly hands down, but certainly feet up. Dave a moment away from 10 points. Hills fans relieved to see that result and being shamelessly upstaged by the overacting Troy the Chicken. It was Ace's amazing courage that won this, launched himself single-handed after the turnaround, and it was all the edge he needed to hit the cushion first. After one event, neither Neil nor Dave is off the mark.
Getting ready to score with the blue balls, it's Jane. Scoring with the red balls, it's Louise. And they're facing Siren and Fox.
This tough twosome have had a fine season, kept the contender scores to the barest minimum in almost every event they contested. Fox against Jane, Louise will face Siren. Louise, a high-scoring power baller in the past. Siren sets about changing all that. How's that for starters? Fox dispenses with Jane's first power ball run. Louise, for some reason, going back to the same basket. Whatever she does with this ball, it won't count. Fox into Jane. Louise down and out of the hands of Siren. Looks to reload now. She needs a plan of action if she's to evade the Siren. Still to work without Siren there again. Jane faring a little better against the Fox. Knows she has an overall 10-point lead at the moment. Tries to go wide, but lacks the pace to outstrip the Fox. Louise bundled out of it by Siren. Less than half a minute remaining. Both girls one-ended. Jane almost leisurely back into action. Fox is there, but not fast enough to stop a score. And Louise in the same basket. 2-2 in the space of 2 seconds. Amazing explosion of activity. You can never second-guess the way this event will go. First you're down, and then you're up. Unless you're tackled by these gladiators, then it's the other way around. The clock running out, it looks like 2-2 will be the final score. Neither girl with the speed and aggression required to make an impact in this event or on the scoreboard. Blink, and you'd have missed both goals. Jane baskets her ball with Fox at her feet, and Louise somehow finds the gap to follow suit.
Well, Louise, it has to be said, we're in the final now. These gladiators aren't messing around.
They're certainly not. I've had 3 runs against Vogue. Unfortunately, she wasn't in the draw this afternoon, so I ended up with Siren, and she's quick.
She certainly was. I mean, they barely let you get away with anything.
Absolutely. I mean, when they're both against us there, I thought maybe I could get round her, but she was on to me.
Certainly was. Let's bring John Anderson in and find out what the correct score is.
Well, I think the girls did very well, especially since the Glads were right on form. They got 2 points each.
Well done. Let's hear it for Louise and Jane.
After the score, let's see the score. Louise with 2, Jane has 12.
We now move into the men's event and scoring with the blue balls, it's Dave. Scoring with the red balls, it's Nilo. They're facing Vulcan and Hunter.
Mean, moody and magnificent. Vulcan's just two of those things and neither of them is magnificent. Who in their right mind would cross him? Neil's a pro rugby star, so this should be his game, but he looked anxious at the thought of facing Vulcan. To work. Very fast at wrong footing, the big fella. 2-point opener for Neil. Knows he needs to score big in this event. His specialist subject, fast footwork again, but Vulcan yanks him back to where he came from and meets out some after-hours punishment as well. Neil's mum and dad, Joe and Dawn, incensed by the Vulcan, but it's what they should expect. Dave against Hunter. Hunter straight in, but somehow Dave staggers to score two. Neil Vulcan takes him from behind, grinds him into the ground and keeps him there. Ref's blown up.
You are holding him down. Can't hack it, leave. Let him up.
I doubt Vulcan will be bothered by that rebuke.
There are 37 seconds remaining. 3, 2, 1.
Neil again. Oh, Vulcan has the measure of him. Neil must do better in this event. It really is his stock in trade. Hunter slams Dave to the deck. It's rough and tumble time on the Powerball pitch. Vulcan again denies Neil with ease. Hunter fells Dave. 18-stone Vulcan, remarkably fast for such a hulking frame. Neil wondering what he's got to do to get past him. Vulcan spins him round like a plaything. Hunter on top of Dave once again.
Neil needs to pull the stops out here. Time's running down. Still can't escape the Dolphin's clutches. He'll have the shirt off your back. Hunter helicopters Dave for a non-too-soft landing. Neil with one last gasp effort. He's got it. Two baskets, 4 points to Neil. Girlfriend Louise demanding Bolton be sent off. Bolton's powerball game plan hasn't changed all season. Smash him down, keep him there.
Bolton was cheating a little bit, it seemed to me, but it didn't seem to faze you at all, Neil.
Nah, okay. Try and keep going. It was tough, but that's what it's all about.
And Dave, it really was a fast one. Hunter was there all the time.
Yeah, he's a great batter here, very hard to beat. I think I managed to score one, which I'd be very pleased with if I did, yeah.
All right, let's find out from John Anderson what the score is.
One of the toughest games yet, two of the best contenders we've ever had. Dave had 2 points, Neil, 4 points.
Well done!
And Vulcan will have to do more preening than that if he's to improve his looks. And look who's got all the points. After two events, Neil has 4, Dave 2. Next up.
Our first female contender is Louise. And she's facing Rio. Over to John Anderson.
Contender ready!
Louise Rains from Preston. We've got her measured like this. 64 kilos, 10 stone, 2 pounds. Rio, on the other hand, is 79 kilos, 12 stone, 7. Now there's a handful. Ref gets them up and at it. Rio has the advantage when it comes to having the weight to bend the poles. Louise has experienced the vertigo twice previously, scored 4 against Lightning and 4 against Fox. Rio climbing well. Louise will be second to the top, 5 poles between herself and the 10-point ring pull. Can she do it? Rio working her first pole, reaches pole 2 with ease, and so does Louise. In fact, Louise hits the front. Louise's friend Kim with little Jessica and Cody swinging with her. Rio from pole 2 to pole 3. Louise leading clearly, moves from 3 to 4. Rio needs to up her pole work if she's to win this. Louise very strong at using her body to make the pole work for her. Louise onto pole 5. She's there, so's Rio. Daughter Kelly optimistic. This for 10 points. Oh, she misses the ring. Rio won't make the same mistake. Rio wins it against the odds. Great effort from Louise. That last pole let her down. You get one chance against Rio. If you blow it, you're out of it. Mum Gloria mortified. Louise went for it, found herself short. Rio doesn't need a second chance to get the job done. Takes the ring, snatches the win.
Our second female contender is Jane. And she's up against Vulcan. Over to John Anderson.
Contender!
Jane Smith from Sheffield, a physical education graduate, represented her country at diving, but she's never experienced these giant poles before. Vulcan, a highly gifted gladiator, has yet to be beaten in this event, so Jane will have more than her work cut out. Vulcan, first to the top, but only just. Leans into pole 2. Jane struggles to make the transfer. Vulcan can turn her hand to anything. If anyone make a job look easy, Vulcan would. Jane onto pole 2. She'll get a point for every pole she completes. Vulcan onto pole 3. Jane with neither the long arms nor the weight to make a clean changeover. Vulcan onto pole 4. One more between her and the winning ring. She's there, moments away from victory. Can Jane add another pole to her list for another point? Vulcan swings it. Good, solid win for Vulcan. The times we've said that this season. Jane gives it up as a bad job. Marie and Andrew know she gave it her best shot. Vulcan down to chalk up another impressive win. And after 3 events, Louise has 6, Jane 14.
It's definitely beginning to hot up here on this year's grand final. Join us after the break here on Gladiators.
Ready! Hit the pendulum!
Watch, man. There's nothing like a drop of Carl McCorf clean on the bagpipes.
John Anderson will kill me.
3, 2, 1.
2 points for every lit section Neil can reach and make flash. There's 10 points in total up for grabs. He's got 2 already, looking for Hunter. Hunter's high and looming large. Neil is off like a scolded bunny. He knows Hunter's reputation. Oh, Hunter's got him big time in no time. Neil's family beginning to realise it's not going quite to plan. Hunter very fast, down and on his man in moments. Hunter with a snatch in this high-action match.
Next up on Pendulum, it's Dave. And he's facing Ace.
The Ace, 105 kilos, 16 stones, 8 pounds in weight. And Dave Walter from Exeter, 94 kilos, which, as I'm sure we all know, makes him a stone lighter.
3, 2, 1!
The lit sectors round the middle are worth 2 each. The section at the South Pole is worth 4, and Dave has 2 already, and Ace is going the wrong way. Dave judging this cat and mouse game superbly well, even at this early stage. Sneaking round for 2 more. His brother Andy and sisters Christine and Bridget giving directions from the stands. Dave in control of this at the moment, coming round on 6 points. Dave registers his highest score in this event. Can he get down to score 10? The Ace doesn't know whether it's Ash Wednesday or Cockfosters, completely oblivious to the fact that Dave is about to score 10 points. He's there, a moment of Gladiators history. 10 points to Dave Walter, and surely that's that. The referee's not blown up. There's nowhere else for Dave to go. John Anderson's so shocked he must have swallowed the pee in his whistle. Dave wondering how long he's going to be left up there. Ah, he's blown it at last. Dave's brother Andy well chuffed with that. Well, Dave saw that Ace was going off in a world of his own, so he seized the chance with both hands and never looked back.
Well, Dave, that looked like a piece of cake, and you've picked just the right moment to pick up your 10 points. You're in the final. You need all the points you can get. Well done. That was fantastic.
Yeah, I've got a little present here for Ace if he wants to come down and pick it up.
Come and get it. It was quite obvious. You absolutely had no idea, really, where he was.
I've never lost a pendulum before. I've never had a pendulum as difficult as that. No matter where I went, I couldn't see him. I thought, he's probably dropped to the bottom, but I thought he wouldn't have done that so early in the game. All I can presume, not seeing it, is we went opposite ways. And
absolutely. You went around one way, he went around the other way. And if you haven't lost before, this is the time to lose it to a man who picks up 10 points.
You told me he was going around that way.
That's it for Ace and Dave. Well done.
With 3 events under their belts, Neil has 6 points, Dave has 12.
Our first female contender is Louise. And she's facing Rebel. Over to John Anderson.
Contender!
It may be the last duel of the season, but Rebel knows this is Louise's first duel in competition. So it shouldn't be too tough for Rebel. Louise giving it some. Former Miss UK bodybuilding champion. Rebel stinging home some short work, not big enough to put her away. Louise coming back, giving it some large. Oh, hard work from her. She's given her a right mullering. But she went across, not a clean knockdown, misjudged her balance, denied herself the points. Son Michael choked. Louise takes the fight to Rebel, overstretches herself and loses her balance. Terrible misfortune for Louise.
Our second female contender is Jane. And she's facing Fox. Over to John Anderson.
Contender!
Jane, a stayer in this event, previously scored 5 against Vogue and 5 against Fox. Jane's come to rumble rather than tumble. She can take a good blow and dish one back, left and right. She knows how to wield a pugil stick in anger, but can she find a steamer to finish Fox? And she's putting all the combinations together. Fox letting rip with the best of them, but she'll need to find something really special to dispatch this resilient contender. Jane soaks up the best that Fox has to offer. Roundhouses, up and overs, recovers the balance well. Fox can't finish it. It's going to be another 5 for Jane. She maintains her undefeated Gladiators dueling record. Fantastic.
Fox commends Jane's performance, and brother Andrew and mum Jenny celebrate the 5 points. Fox had one good opportunity, slapped Jane's stick, brought her forward, but failed to finish her off. After four events in the final, Louise stays on 6, Jane moves to 19.
Our first male contender is Neil! And he's up against Vulcan!
Events John Anderson.
Contender!
Get on with it, says Vulcan. He has dire retribution to mete out. Neil took 4 points from him on the Powerball earlier, and that has to be payback big time. 18 stones of solid revenge.
It's hammer time.
Neil ducked by Vulcan, but Vulcan unloads a monster. Neil recoils in horror, and Neil's family are stunned. No points for Neil, and sneering satisfaction for the Vulcan.
You look a bit disappointed.
Just a bit. Can't believe that.
It's pretty tasty out there.
He was, but I wanted to make more of that, you know. I needed to stay on it, but, yeah, he beat me for fair and square.
Vulcan, I think, for the first time in this series, I'm going to give you some praise. You are very awesome out there.
Well, let me tell you something, Jeremy. Do you know, I am getting sick of people want to come in here and knock me off. This is my game, you know. And Wolfman, to you, my friend, you said this man is the best thing ever. You're kidding me, man. He's not a man, he's a boy.
All right. As usual, you're losing it a bit, Vulcan, but never mind. Let's give it up for Neil. Our second male contender is Dave. And he's up against Rhino.
Over to John Anderson.
I've not heard pipes make that kind of row since the plumbing in my bathroom went wrong.
Dave tries an early blast, fails to make contact. Dave's never scored on duel before. He whackles Rhino. The Glad's in for a tough time here. Dave throwing some serious bombs in there in Rhino's direction. Rhino in trouble, but he recovers. Oh, Dave getting troubled by body shots. Rhino needs to let a big one go to force Dave back. Incredible dueling from Dave. Caught the Rhino more than once. Oh, looks like Dave's on for a sensational 5 points for staying the distance. Rhino doesn't know what he has to do to put this man away. Oh, roundhouse. Oh, he's gone. Overbalances with a tenth of a second remaining. Rhino relieved, his blushes have been spared, but a tragedy for Dave. Dave forces Rhino back with a fierce jab, commits to a big right, takes himself down.
It looks as though you're going to be holding on for 5 points, but I think you just came off.
I saw the 10 points there. Went for the big hit and the big man ducked. Good tactic. And I had everything in that hit.
Rhino, you could tell how pleased you were at the end. I thought the guy was going to stay up.
I must have the utmost respect for Dave. He knows what he's doing. You might make out he's calm, cool and collective, but he's focused.
Top performance by Rhino. Let's give it up for Dave and Rhino.
Top performance by Rhino is a bit of an exaggeration, but Rhino generous with his praise. Four events down, one to go. Neil stays on 6, Dave remains on 12.
And first up, it's Louise. And she's facing Vulcan.
Vulcan's never been beaten on the rings. One of the most popular glads of all time. Season after season, she gets the job done with a minimum of fuss. Hello, someone thinks they've come to see Gardner's World.
Over to John Anderson.
Contender ready! And you go ready! 3, 2, 1!
Vulcan will remember she beat Louise on Hang Tough in the quarterfinals. At least Louise knows how Vulcan operates. The question is, can she turn that to her advantage? Louise in trouble, unforced error, just manages to hold on. Her grip, suspect. The red rings are where the points are, and Louise well short of those at the moment. Vulcan looking to get it finished, figuring out the most efficient tactic. Vulcan within striking distance, decides her position isn't right, retreats for a better purchase on the situation. Louise making a break for it on the right. Red ring, less than half a minute to go. Vulcan one ringed, then sorts herself out, back on track. Louise is happy to stay where she is and let the Vulcan do all the work. Louise is quite safe where she is, but it must be pointed out she's not wearing handguards, and you don't want to do that. You don't get much grip without those handguards. It's buried. Oh, look at that. She's gone. Louise forgets to hold on. What a terrible mistake. She said her grip was suspect, but blows it with less than 8 seconds to go. Louise could kick herself for that. Finds herself one ringed and then no ringed.
Next up on Mount Top, it's Jane. And she's facing Vogue.
Vogue will have consulted the record books and seen that Jane has been on the rings once before in competition. That was last week when she lost to Falcon. Jane, 64 kilos, 10 stone. So with Vogue at 10 stone 10, my guess is the Gladiator will be carrying 10 more pounds of weight in this particular contest.
Over to John Anderson.
Contender ready! Table ready!
Here we go.
3, 2, 1.
Vogue with plenty of muscle power at her disposal and looking to dispose of Jane as fast as she possibly can. Vogue watching Jane Smith's big confident swings, almost into the scoring zone. Reverses her way out of trouble. Excellent work from Jane, always aware of Vogue's position. Plenty of space between her and trouble. Oh, doesn't she swing well? On the left wing, on a red ring, where's she going? Oh, straight into the flying scissors of Vogue out of nowhere. Jane beats it up as a bad job. Well, no point in wasting energy she can more profitably use on the Eliminator. Jane's boyfriend, Andy, dancing, that's what we call it. Vogue's deceptively accurate swing trapped Jane, so Jane rightly figured the best course of action was downward. 5 events completed, Louise has 6, Jane 19. The crowd erupts because it's you-know-who. Everyone loves the Wolfman, even that hairy child with a big mouth. He's been the butt of many a joke, but with the odd exception, the old fella's a real crowd-pleaser, one of the great television characters. See what this dog of war is made of. 95 kilos, 15 stones of solid lupine muscle. Coming the other way will be Neil Parsley, 86 kilos, 1.5 stones lighter.
Over to John Anderson.
Contender ready! Ready to go! Ready! 3, 2, 1!
So far in the season, Neil has faced Wolf and Saracen on the rings, and he's been beaten by both of them. So he'll be keen to offset the hat-trick for the Glads. Wolf straight away at Neil's side. Tries to get a piece. He spins himself into trouble. Needs to recover before he has another pop. Retreating to get a better angle. Such an intimidating sight. Reversing to engage Neil. Neil could do without this. Legs up. Good defensive work from Neil. A Wolf locks onto a leg. It'll take a sailor to untie that knot. Wolf with a piece of vest. I hope that's not skin as well. Less than 20 seconds. Neil will score 5 if he hangs tough until the whistle. Wolf needs to get a better grip. Oh, that should do it. Great work from Wolf. Glad you agree, madam. But Neil's family can't believe he's failed to score again. Wolf makes contact, and once he's got you in his grasp, there are two options. Either grit your teeth or hit the deck.
To start with.
Oh, yeah.
But you did very well because you traversed as far away from him as possible. I actually think that your legs were a little bit too high.
Let me just tell you, it was a good game, it was pretty fair. This guy is the best in the country to get this far.
Wolf once again trying to make some friends.
Can you just ask me one question? Did you put makeup on before you came out? Because you could have fooled me.
It's in for Neil and not for Wolf.
Sense of humour lost by our presenter there, and it'll take a boil wash to get that out. Here's the Beastie Boy going head-to-head with Troy the Chicken, or Lunch as Wolf would call him. Wolf getting a pasting from the chickens. Hello. The Vikings have arrived. They should have been here 800 years ago. What kept you? Wolf has now removed the chicken's head, and if you've just joined us, you're not watching the South Bank show. It's Gladiators. And finally, the secret identity of Chicken Man is revealed. So there it is, a grown man wearing a washed-out tea towel, proudly parading a giant chicken head. But it's good to see that Wolf hasn't compromised the dignity of this grand final of sporting and physical excellence.
Next up in the men's event, it's Dave. And he's facing the one and only Saracen.
One of the originals and still one of the greatest. But the Chickettes confident of Dave's success in this event. The last gladiator contender conflict of this season, and the capacity crowd are really up for it. And one of the best-known faces on television, and one of the best-known pair of shoulders as well. Dave Walter has jinxed the Glads right from his first heat. A point-scoring powerhouse, seems to be a dab hand at every event he tries. He's well into the scoring zone. There's 10 points waiting at Sarah's platform, 5 if he's still on a red ring come the timeout Uta. Dave attacking the platform single-handed, but Saracen marking him out. Half a minute left. Dave with his back to Sarah, but Sarah reluctant to make a move until Dave does. Sarah has Dave pretty much in check, so Dave needs to stay out of trouble. Dave commits and misses a ring. Sarah digs in, spins himself into trouble, but Dave too far away to make the most of it. Dave content to hang on for the 5. Exceptional piece of intelligent hang-tough tactical play by both guys. Reminds me of Kasparov and Fischer in one of those chess master marathon games. 5 points for Dave Walter, a real bonus going into the eliminator. Dave's family rejoice. Dave took a shot at Saracen's platform. Sarah warned him off with a glancing blow, so Dave decided that discretion was the better part of valor. After 5 long, tough events, Neil has made 6 points, Dave 17.
But waiting just around the corner, the assault course from hell. Join us after the break here on Gladiators.
The Gladiators! The Gladiators!
Welcome back to the National Indoor Arena here in Birmingham and to our final eliminators. Now, in the women's event, Louise is on 6 points, James on 19 points. That's a 13-point difference, giving Jane a 6.5-second head start in the eliminator. Over to Jeremy.
Jane, this is crunch time, but 6.5-second lead. Nice one.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, still anything can happen. Travelator's very fast. You know, you just got to keep pushing all the way. It's a big one.
Louise against Trudy in the semi-finals. She had a 4-second lead. You managed to eat up that and win. Can you do it again?
I'm going to give it everything I've got to try and close that gap early on. And we'll just have to see.
Okay, I wish you both the best of luck, and I'll see you at the finish.
The tension is incredible. Louise's mum, Gloria, can hardly stand it. The ladies' final. Louise Rains versus Jane Smith.
Jane, you will go on my first whistle. Louise, you will go on my second whistle. 3, 2, 1.
Jane attacks the eliminator for the very last time, but it's never been more crucial. The coveted title of Women's Gladiator Champion is at stake. One of those fabulous four-wheel drive trucks awaits the winner. Hot pursuit comes from Louise, a Preston-based mother of 3. And Louise bounces to the net with plenty to do and 6.5 seconds to make up. Jane up to the rope climb. The hand ladder will be a test of upper body strength. Jane, the fastest woman ever around the eliminated course. Louise snagged on the net. Daughter Grace willing her mum up the rope. Swing time for Jane makes the change in the major cargo net, her next hurdle. Boyfriend Andy hardly able to bear the tension. Louise laddering over the chasm of lost souls, which holds a 10-second penalty for those who plunge into the dark recesses. Trapeze for Louise. She'll reach the foot of the net as Jane hits the top. It's dig deep into the courage bank time again. Louise can only rely on a mistake from Jane now. Zipper for Jane. Every time she runs this course, she gets faster. Graveyard next. Louise struggling on the net. Her mum, Gloria, in agony. Jane, first seesaw, brave and balanced, sprinting faster on the beam than most people can manage on the flat. Remarkable athletic skills from this 22-year-old Sheffield girl. Louise finishes her climb. Jane for the championship. The Travelator can't stop her. Jane Smith, Gladiators champion 1998. Her Nan Alice, along with Marie and Andrew, lead the adulation. Louise, a magnificent runner-up. There's a cheque for £1,000 and a first-class Bahamas holiday waiting for her and the family at the top of this travelator. Louise Rains finishes her run in style.
Jane, champion Gladiator 1998. Very simple question, how does it feel?
I just can't believe it. I thought I was going to stumble on the travelator. It feels absolutely amazing. It has been fantastic. Louise, you know, she kept pushing all the way. She's a lovely lady. Everyone says that, but I just can't believe it.
Well, you look and sound completely overjoyed, overwhelmed as well. Here is £1,000. Here's your trophy. Oh, it's heavy. And the prize that I think you really want. There are the keys. Let's give it up for Jane Smith. Woo!
Well, as you know, Louise, there can only be one true and absolute winner, but you've been cracking to get this far, and it just looked as if you were having a little bit of trouble there on the cargo net.
Yeah, I slipped a couple of times and put my foot right through, but I finally got up the travelator without using my knees.
Well, that's terrific, and it may just be as a small bit of compensation, but in this envelope, there's £1,000 and, I believe, some tickets for a holiday in the Bahamas, which I know you quite fancy.
It'll be absolutely fantastic. We've not been away for ages, so I'm really looking forward to having a bit of time with the family.
Here. It's your trophy. Let's hear it for Louise Rains.
But to the victor, the glory and the spoils. Boyfriend Andy congratulating Jane. Here's Dad, Julian. And Louise telling her children not to cry. She was a fabulous contender.
Jane, I've just got to stop you for a second. We've got some more good news for you. Your time through the eliminator in the semi-finals of 1:17 is the fastest of the whole series, and you get another £1,000.
But the excitement isn't over yet, because in the men's final, Dave's lead of 11 points will give him a 5.5-second advantage at the start of this next eliminator.
Well, Neil, I have to say, this is where it's at. You're now dependent upon your last remnants of strength and, of course, your crowd who've been behind you throughout this.
Yeah, I'm going to give it everything I've got. I know they're all behind me. I'm just going to give it everything I've got.
And I have to say, Dave, you know you've done very well tonight, but, of course, this is where it all happens.
This is where it all happens, yeah, but as we've seen so many times, those of us that watch this eliminator, anything can happen, so we've both got to stay focused and just do our jobs.
Absolutely. The very best of luck to Dave and to Neil. We'll see you both at the end. Over to John Anderson.
The chickettes are ready. Troy the chicken's got his head back on. The dance needs a bit of attention, but Dave's fans have been tremendous. His dad right behind him. Dave Walter versus Neil Parsley. Neil's friend Robbo requesting celestial intervention, along with members of Neil's family.
Dave, you will go on my first whistle. Neil, you will go on my second whistle. 3, 2, 1.
This is it. The only man to go faster than Jane Smith round this eliminator course is Dave Walter, which must be a huge worry for Neil Parsley. Dave's best run timed at 1:13. Neil's at 1:23. Dave over the net. Good, deep plunge. Neil on the other side. Girlfriend Louise wringing her hands as Dave up the rope in one. Neil on the downside. Bike ride for Dave. Neil to the rope. Dave's struggling on the bike. Neil closing him down. Dave's brother and sister can see the danger. Neil eating into that gap with tremendous speed. Dave over the valley of death gears himself for the giant cargo climb. Neil with a swing. Those 5.5 seconds whisked away. Dave's mum Molly and his sister Carol screaming for him to go faster. Dave with such stamina, he can keep going while others fade away. Gantry run to the farthest zip line. Leaps to the T-bar. Launches himself into oblivion. Good controlled landing. Neil next for the line. Ooh, awkward impact. Louise doesn't like it. Dave, seesaw. Good balance, plenty of control. Neil with everything to do and little time to do it in. Dave to the travelator. This for the men's championship. He's there. just Dave Walter, the fast food supervisor from Exeter, men's champion of Gladiators 1998. Neil acknowledges the support of his family and friends. His race is run.
Dave Walters, you are the champion of Gladiators 1998. You've got to be so pleased.
Yeah, very pleased, ecstatic.
Come on, really tell us how you're feeling deep down. I mean, on the outside, you always look calm, cool. You know, I said at the beginning of the show, very unassuming. You've got to be delighted.
All right, I'm really chuffed, everybody.
Well, you're going to be even more pleased. There's the trophy. Woo! A very heavy trophy. There's £1,000. There's an extra £1,000 for you as well, Dave, because you ran the first eliminator time tonight of 1:13. So that's £2,000 in total, plus the keys to the truck. Man, you deserve a nice drive, a nice drink, a nice hot toddy, I think.
Thank you very much, Jeremy.
Let's get up for Dave Walter.
Not to worry. Absolutely loved it. I'd just like to thank everyone there. Obviously, girlfriend Louise. I couldn't have done it without them. Top crowd. And I just say congratulations to Dave. Brilliant competitor. So good on the games. And he's fast on this.
He certainly was. But well done to you, because, of course, you've got this far. Now, there's your trophy. Beware, it's quite heavy. Probably not up to lifting this right now. Now, in here is £1,000. And a holiday for two in the Bahamas. I don't need to ask who's going with you, do I?
Not at all. She knows she is.
Let's hear it for Louise as well. And well done, Neil!
As Katie and Louise embrace, the calmest man in the arena is the 1998 champion, Dave Walter. That's his tiny niece, Charlotte. Great family man. Neil Parsley, the valiant runner-up, with his lady.
Well, that's it for another series.
And what a great series it's been, and what fantastic new champions we've got. But of course, we'll be back before too long with more action here on Gladiators. Good night.
So as the champions celebrate their victory in the arena, let's relive some of the great moments we've enjoyed this season. And remember, for safety reasons, please don't try to recreate any of the events you've seen on Gladiators.
Well, Sunday wouldn't be Sunday without a bit of bully. So, as Jim is now counting how many speedboats he's got left, we'll get ready to join him for Bullseye next. Then, after that, we'll see if Nick Hancock and Michelle Collins can win money for their charities. It's the Chase Celebrity Special at 9.